In this video, we're going to talk about and solve a problem involving many-to-many relationships. Do you guys like many-to-many relationships? Oh yeah, let's go. All right, so this question was asked by Mahindra Bisram on our talk Power BI. And Mahindra's from New York, and he brought it up in our talk Power BI live session last time. By the way, guys, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you can join us the next time we go live to answer your Power BI questions. And that happens every single Friday. We hang out and have fun. And that's where we were hanging out with Mahindra. Now, I wasn't able to solve this in the session itself, and which is good. That's the highlight of Talk Power BI. You get to watch me fail and get egg on my face, fall flat on my face, all of that stuff, right? And that's the fun of it. You know, I like the process of, getting stuck and then solving it, right? So here we go. So let me line up the problem with you. Here's what's going on here. It's really simple. We have content and we have activity, and we have content has different topics. So again, I'm gonna refer back to my talk Power BI notes. So content could be a blog, videos, white paper, etc., right? And you can imagine that one content, so each content is represented by a content ID in the data set. By the way, you can get this file on by just going to learnpowerbi.com/download. You can get this file and work through the problem yourself or look at the solution. So the content, that's the content. I was eating my notes. So content, we have blog, video, white paper, and on, right? Now, each content represented by the content ID can have one or more topics. Makes sense. I just wrote a blog post recently about my trip to Banff National Park. It was beautiful. And you can imagine that can have topics like Banff, travel, vacation, family, on, right? So each content can have many content topics. Fair enough? And each content, each piece, once I publish that blog, it's going to have activity. It's going to have views. And of course, depending on the content type, the activity itself can be different. It's going to be recognized by this activity ID. But, so imagine videos can have views, white papers can have downloads, maybe videos can have both views and download, right? So all of that structure is there, and this is set up well for that regard. So let me show you what the problem was occurring. So again, Mahindra demonstrated that in the Talk Power BI call. So what we're doing is we're selecting one topic. So again, the topic is coming from this. I'm going to move this table down over here. So the topic is coming from here. I will talk about relationship bidirections in a little bit. But we filter down to a specific topic, and he showed these files. And he said, Avi, the right answer in this one is 16. And he did have a measure which was returning 16. And I'm like, awesome. Well, what are you here for? Like, I mean, you know, you got it solved. Well, not so fast, because he showed B2B. And here, this measure doesn't work. The right answer in this case is 20. So again, he has one measure which works in one case, another measure works in another case. And of course, you could do some kind of a mashup where you say, if this, then use this measure. If that, then use this measure. But again, what I like to do in these cases is to understand why it's not working and just focus on the model itself. So again, I set out to solve it. So let's go back and focus on the model. And the model is fairly clean, but I'm going to make some tweaks. For one, the default for you should be one-to-many relationship, just like this one. So that's the default that I look for. Anything else is an exception, and you better be able to explain that exception to me. So this one, so again, it's good to start with the default and then change it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change both of these to single direction and single direction, and then come back and try to solve it. So again, I will change this one as well. All right, this would probably break things in the report, but so now if I go back and think about, so notice the numbers are kind of wonky now, but now when I think about, well, I'm trying to filter it by topic and I want the activity to be filtered. So now I go back here and I say, okay, so where's my filter? Let's see if I can, am any good at drawing. So that's my filter, right? Oh boy, that's a pretty nice looking filter. Wouldn't you say, hey, hit the like button, my friend, if you liked my drawing of the filter. Okay, just kidding. Oh, you can still hit the like button. All right, so that's the filter. And then we expect, so filter, what are relationships? Relationships are filter transmission wire. So we want this filter, which is on this table, to be boop, 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 transmitted here, and then boop, 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 you know, transmitted down here. But filter relationships, by default, the filters flow downhill. So this part is good, my friend. You know, this one is downhill, right? You notice how this table is downhill from here? It's going to work. This one is uphill, so it's not going to work by default. So again, we need to understand that, and then we're going to say, oh, so I need this relationship to filter uphill, so I'm going to change this to bi-directional. Now, there's another thing here, which is probably this one, this table shouldn't be set up this way. Probably our topic hierarchy should be here, and this should map the content ID with the topic ID, right? So this is the proper way that I would say would be set up, but we'll work with this for now. All right, cool. So we have this set up. So now when I ask the question that Mahendra was asking, it's like, oh, I want to see activity by topic, activity by topic. And I'm like, there shouldn't be anything special we need to do because the filter flows up here, filter flows down here. So if I want to see activity, I'll just count the activity. So in my mind, that's the measure. So let's go ahead and define that measure. All right, so I'm just going to click modeling, new measure. And when the dialog box comes up anytime soon, there we go. I'm just going to say count activity equals count rows activity. Doesn't get any simple than that. And now I have activity by topic type. So let's try to analyze it. So I created a new page and I'm just going to put count activity there. And then here, I'm going to go here and I will add the different levels, topic level one, topic level two, and they're all going to be kind of drill downs and so forth. And of course, let me quickly make a matrix as well. I'll be right back. All right, there we go. So now I have it in a graph over here, in a matrix over here, and I'm convinced that this is right. This is really simple, and yeah, you can drill down and to whatever level, and same thing here. You can go drill down in brand, and go now we're looking at level two, and let's look at content marketing, and I think this the level threes disappear for some of them, but that's okay, right? So as long as the data would be there, it would show up. But let's go back to Mahendra's original problem of this weird count where he was expecting something else. So again, I'm going to ignore this last topics one. So let's go back here. I'm going to select this visual and bring in our count activity. Count activity, nope, not here. Avi's measure. And all right, so again, this is giving the right answer, 20, great. But then go back to the next scenario of agency, and it's it's not giving the right answer. It's showing 14, and we had said we wanted the higher number, 16. So then I dove in and investigated. It's like, well, what's going on? What is the part that's not working? So I'm going to copy that table, and I'm going to just pretty much keep the ID, the content ID there, and see how these measures are working, and I see that the 16, the right answer, is expecting some of these activities to be counted twice. Now again, this is unusual. So what they're saying is that if there's one content, one blog, and two topics, if it was read once, I still want to count it twice, right? So it was listed under two topics. So, and you can see that here. So if I click on this, so again, they're expecting the right answer for this content ID to be two. Now, there's only one activity, right? Because there's only one activity ID on this date. So one person probably read it or something. But if it has two different topics at topic level two, count it twice. So again, kind of an unusual scenario, but that's why real data is so fun, because it's not always textbook. So there could be different ways to solve it, but the way I'm going to solve it is this way. So basically, I'm saying, no, I don't care about topic level one. If there are multiple topic level twos, I want that to be counted each time. So what I'm going to do is basically create a measure which calculates the same count activity, but does it by each topic level two, each topic level two. So I'm gonna say count activity by topic level two, and then go, so this is gonna go topic by topic at the level two. So that does mean that I'm gonna use an iterator function. So basically I know it's gonna be some kind of iterator function, and I think it's gonna be sum. So let's just start with that. So sum x, and what am I iterating over? Well, topic level two. So whatever topic level twos are available to me. So I'm gonna say values, topic level 2, right? So this is going to give me the table that the sum x is going to iterate over. And then for each of these, what do I want? I just want the activity. Oh, it's count activity. So I'm going to use the new measure that I created, that I just created, right? So that's it. And so let's put this, make sure it's in the right spot. And we're going to add it to our table here. Might as well delete this guy. And in this table, I'm going to add the count activity, and I'm going to add it in this the lower table as well. But you can see that we're getting the right answer, 16 here. Let's just check the other scenario, B2B, make sure that that's still working, and that's working 20. So great. So again, folks, to recap, we have a many-to-many scenario, which normally there wouldn't be any heavy lifting involved as long as it's set up this way. The only change that I would recommend is having a mapping table over here for the topic level. So that would be moved up here. And that's it. And normally you would just do count rows activity, but we had a slight wrinkle of the specific requirement of how this needed to be counted in our case. So hey, if you have any questions, join us for Talk Power BI Live. I go live every Friday, and that's a chance to kind of hang out, discuss, ask your questions, hang out with other cool folks, and once in a while, watch me fail. All right, until next time, power on, my friends.